Yo, what's going on, guys? JBH here, and today I'm back on Assetto Corsa Competizione, where we are hitting up Brands Hatch in what is sort of a recreation of the Blancpain GT World Challenge Sprint Cup or Sprint Series. I actually don't know what it's called now. I just know it as the Blancpain Sprint Series. So yeah, we're going to be doing a quick 15-minute race, which is around half of what a driver would do in a real-life stint around there. I've got it set to the highest difficulty as well as sort of max damage, so it's all as realistic as it can be. I've also got all the assists sort of switched off, except for like the whole factory ABS and TC and whatnot that you have usually in GT3 racing. I've got 24 AI cars set for this race, and in terms of the car that I'm going to be driving, usually I let it go down to the... I've got 24 cars set in terms of the AI, however, the car that I'm going to be driving, I'm going to decide through this sort of wheel of names spinner. It just gives me a chance to drive every single car. Plus, there's so many cool GT3 cars on this game, I can never make my mind up. Now, last time I drove the Mercedes AMG at Bathurst, so I've taken that one off the list, and the rest, sort of all the brands that are available in the Sprint Series on the Assetto Corsa Competizione platform. So, without any further ado, we'll spin this wheel. What are we going to get? Oh, it's German Porsche. I haven't driven this car on here before, so this should be interesting. And there's only one paint scheme we can actually choose from, and that is the sort of Dynamic Motorsports Porsche 54 car, driven by Sven Müller and Giorgio Roda. Alrighty, well, without any further ado, we'll jump straight into this video. I'm going to go do a quick qualifying session and set the grid, and yeah, we'll see how we go. Alrighty, so qualifying is done. Safe to say I am slow as anything around here. I think we qualified all the way down in 20th. We're like a second to a second half off the pace, so it's not looking good going into this race. However, if we could just hold on to the pack, maybe make some moves in the pit stop. There is one pit stop. It's weird having a pit stop in a 15-minute race, but it is sort of a required stop that has to happen in this sort of format. But yeah, anyway, without any further ado, we'll jump onto the grid and get underway. Now, it is a rolling start, so we've got a quick formation lap to get through. Alrighty, here we go, just rounding the second to last corner. Time to get this race underway. The Blancpain GT World Challenge around the Brands Hatch circuit. All the way back to row number 10. 20th, we've got super cold tyres. It is cloudy, so it's going to be a sketchy start to the race. As I mentioned, Brands Hatch has one heck of an insane first corner anyway. Chunk it first. Frame rate's dropping now. We got all the cars. Getting a little FPS drop, so we have to go. graphic settings. Man, I do love this game. This game is absolutely insane. How realistic it looks, how these cars handle.
Thank you.
All right. Halfway through. Stop these bugs. Oh, shit. Stop the engine. Oh, shit. Oops. All right, well, I have an Aston right in front of me.
We're going off quite a bit there. Not over yet.
I gotta start this engine as soon as we got.
Turned off in time, but it's okay.
definitely the bend here. This and the Aston, and these, between these two, that is a handful. Oh shit, so this is the second last lap. Race in the world, struggled quite a bit there for pace, and then obviously had that stupid mistake. We actually gained 6 spots in the first lap, but couldn't gain any more than that. Anyway, guys, thanks for tuning in. Hope you've enjoyed it. Definitely not the most, the most entertaining race out there, but yeah, anyway, on to the next one. Until next time, catch you guys later.